Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. We're still at the bar with Dr. Danny Lamm. Hi, Danny.
Hiya, Henry.
We've got a lot to cover in this world of Michigas, because the world has gone mad. It's all reversed, turned upside down, and we're trying to get some sense of semblance of order, you know. And one thing that we do every year is we commemorate, especially the Jewish people, we have Jewish festivals, and every one of them has significance. And last week we had a very important moment where we remembered, and we should be doing it every day, International Holocaust Remembrance Day.
Absolutely, Henry. And actually, use the word mishigas. For us, we think everything's mishuga. But the word we should be talking about is Russia. Evil. Evil.
Oh, the evil axis. Okay.
No, I didn't mean the country of Russia. I meant the Ivrit word Russia.
Rashut.
Rashut, which is you know, evil.
Evil.
And now we're confronting evil. Mm. And if you talk about International Holocaust Remembrance, that was, you know, the nth degree of evil in the murder of our people. And in relation to that, the terminology genocide has been used now in a very ridiculous way, and South Africa did it. Yeah. South Africa is the one that brought it to the ICJ. It's appalling. And by the way, I have to tell you, I was in South Africa recently, and I have to tell you that the South African people themselves are not anti-Semitic. No. They're not even anti-Israel. No. And they were telling me, we're with you. But the government is hostile, the ANC, and they brought this spurious claim to the ICJ,
yes,
and Israel defended it. And it was pretty impressive, because one of our Melbourne boys, Tal Becker, led the team. A graduate of Yavne College, a member of our Jewish community in Mizrahi. He led it, and he led it with distinction, in enabling people to hear the truth. Nevertheless, people vote with it's political what they do, and there are 57. Nations in the UN, all affiliated with the Islamic world in one way or another, who automatically tip the balance. And that comes out in every country. So when Israel is ably defended in the United Nations by its ambassador there, who's doing a fantastic job.
Fantastic.
He's doing a fantastic job. Israel expresses the emet, and the other side simply has no interest in that. So our responsibility is to put light onto that area. But in relation to what Israel's done, Israel has made every effort, and always has, to have the highest morality of the conduct of the IDF. Somebody as important as Colonel Richard Kemp was the one who said there is no army like Israel in terms of morality, and we've lost chayalim, korbanot, sacrifices, good boys and girls, all young, all committed, and have died in fighting this particular war.
Yeah, we have a lot of courageous people in Israel, whereas I think that the other side, the opposition and the people that we're fighting, are basically cowards, because they're hiding in tunnels.
Hiding behind their people.
Their people.
The conduct is simply terrible.
We treasure life. We really believe that life is more chai is our l'chaim.
L'chaim, 100%.
All about life.
And this is the challenge that the government of Israel faces in how to prosecute this war, because what they could have done is they could have carpet bombed the whole thing, churned it up, destroyed it to 60 or 70 metres down, no tunnels, no people, no nothing, lay the land fallow so that nobody can actually reside there at all. And Israel can be safer. But Israel doesn't do that and hasn't done that. And that's an important message. And one of the outrageous things is that there's an organisation called UNRWA who is funded by the world, including this country, and Penny Wong, you know, God forgive, I mean, I cannot understand giving money and then saying she had a discussion over the table and they promise that they'll use the money only ethically, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Like, anyway, so the UNRWA is a terrible thing, and now we find that the UNRWA are abetting and abetting and members of Hamas.
Yeah.
Which Israel has claimed the whole time.
They're overlapped. I mean, we've known about this for years.
Yeah, and the world...
How corrupt they are.
How corrupt they
and
are.
And how instilled they are in the Gazan mentality with Hamas as their leaders. And Hamas doesn't do anything for their people. All they do is keep them impoverished.
Keep them subjugated to the will of Hamas. And the will of Hamas is ultimately... directed towards killing Jews.
Yeah, and taking over Israel. I mean, we know that it's in their charter from, you know, the earliest days that they started, and their connection with the Islamic Brotherhood.
With the Muslim Brotherhood.
The Muslim Brotherhood is very, very strong. They tried to water it down a bit.
It is really important for everybody to understand the Jews are the indigenous population of Israel.
Yeah.
And before the establishment of the state in 1948, when people spoke about Palestinians, they meant the Jews who live there. That's our background. We've been there for 3,300 years.
Yep.
And not take a backward step when unions here and left-wing politicians attempt to sell the argument that it's the Palestinians.
Yeah, it's the rewriting of history. They're rewriting history, and we need to get the truth out there, and that's why I do the shtick, and that's why I have people like you come on, because you've got your finger on the pulse.
So, I'm involved here in many different things, and I'm involved in Israel on many different things, and in fact, in a couple of weeks, I'll be in Israel again for meetings of the Board of Governors of the Jewish Agency and meetings of the executive of the World Zionist Organization, the Vada Poel, the Zionist General Council. And we try to maintain a frequent connection with Israel, because it's the place that we love. It's the place that we care about. Mm. Israel is the centrality of Jewish life in the world.
Yep.
Israel is the guarantor for the Jewish world, for the diaspora. And we're lucky to be living in this particular generation, notwithstanding the losses that we've suffered.
Yeah, well, it's in our DNA. Both our parents your parents particularly were very involved in the Jewish community, and my parents not so much, but they were Holocaust survivors. I mean, truly sole survivors of the Holocaust. So through them, I've been I've been indoctrinated into Zionism, in a sense, just through osmosis, just being around it, being Jewish. And it's a beautiful thing. I love being Jewish, right? I would not be anything else. I have no enemies. It's just that our enemies don't like us, and we've got to struggle. And in our lifetime, we are now facing the same kind of threat, in a sense, not as heavy as the Nazis, but this could be even worse.
Look, I don't know about worse. I mean, there are 1.8 billion Muslims in the world. That is a tremendous threat compared to our 16 million Jews. But we do have the State of Israel, and we have to give the strongest support we possibly can. We live in a fantastic country, and it's our responsibility here in Australia to get the message out and ensure that government after government conducts itself, recognising that that every citizen of Australia has equal rights. Mm. But our Jewish community has made a fantastic contribution. Well, look, we've been here in Melbourne since 1835. We've got deep, deep roots, and we support the country, and the country has to support us.
Well, they do in many ways. I mean, particularly further on the right, but it's just the extreme left and the Marxists. And haven't even touched on the campus issue, you know, because we've got all these people, the intellectual, you know, paparazzi. They're just mad.
It's important you say extreme left, because my experience with premiers Steve Bracks and John Brumby and Daniel Andrews who are from the Labor Party,
yeah.
have all been extremely positive. It's been yeah. a pleasure to work with them, as it was with Ted Bailey.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just talking in the last 20, 25 years, you know. But there are some people pulling the strings who are of far-left ideologies, unionists, who are misusing the unions, and that and the Muslim populations of certain electorates. Mm. And
particularly in Sydney.
In the west side of Sydney, you know, so that some of those ministers, you know, are affected by that, and that comes out in certain of the things that's happened. And, you know, I can't express my disappointment more clearly in Penny Wong and to a lesser extent, but still the Prime Minister as well. They haven't done enough.
No.
And they can put a stop to all this stuff.
Mm.
And they have to, because people are feeling threatened.
We'll have you back just to help us through the last segment with some clips as well. So we'll be back after the break with more of Danny Lamm.